And with me in the studio to shed more light on all of this conversation going on is public affairs analyst Biodun Shoumi. Good to have you here.
I'm pleased to be here.
Now, what do you make of all of this going on in Ekiti between FIME and, of course, the Alawe? I believe that's the right pronunciation.
Yes, it's Alawe of Ilawe. Ilawe.
Mm-hmm.
We need to understand a little bit about the history of what happened. Ekiti, people are united. They are the same people, no different tribe or anything. They're just one people. Now, Governor Kaude came into office and decided to appoint the Alawe of Ilawe Ekiti as a permanent chairman of the Council of Obas. The Alawe is a junior oba to some prominent monarchs like the Iwi of Ado Ekiti.
Right.
So they kicked against it and said no, they will not accept that. I must stress it that Kaude himself is not from Ilawe, and he's from Ishan Ekiti, which is far away from Ilawe. So there's no question of whether he tried to advantage his own king. But then the other Oba kicked against it, 16 of them, and then decided to boycott the statutory meetings of the Council of Obas since August last year. Oh, the governor was piqued by that development. That issue was not resolved. The negotiation took place. The Obas, the 16 Obas, decided to stick to their guns. They are all first class Obas. So then that is the crisis which has to be dealt with. On one part, they are quite right. The Obas are right. You cannot expect senior Obas, you know, to kowtow to the dictates or the chairmanship of a junior Oba. In Yoruba land, it's quite unlike the Yoruba people. There's an hierarchical way. It's not cultural. There's an hierarchical way of doing things. People know who is a first class, second class, and others. Even among the first class, we know we have paramount rulers. Even then, we even know those who are historical Obas that appear to be more advantageous. So consequently, the Obas kicked against it and the government has not been able to resolve it. But the government is also right on another score, because Obas are paid from the public post. They are public officers and they're expected to perform certain public functions. So one of that is the statutory meetings of the Oba, monthly statutory meetings of the traditional council, which the 16 Obas are boycotting. So that is where the dilemma is. If they don't go back to perform those statutory functions, simply because the current chairman is Alawe of Ilawe Ekiti, who they considered as junior, then the governor will continue to have a problem. How do you continue to allow a situation where public officers like Obas are not performing their roles and they are being paid? Meanwhile, he cannot withdraw their entitlements because he's paid, you know, by the traditional council. So that is really where the dilemma is.
There's a big dilemma, I can say.
Yes, that is where it is. So the governor, in an attempt to resolve the problem, even though the timing is wrong, following Sanusi's removal, you know, and he decided to say, okay, look, they would have to explain why they are boycotting statutory meetings. And it is that query, rather than clarification, which already the government knows. You know, that is where the problem lies. You cannot query an Oba in Yoruba culture. Nobody can. No governor can. You can choose to remove an Oba, but you cannot query an Oba. That is the truth of the matter. So trying to query an Oba, you know, will open a new chapter in the history of the Yoruba people. People should not forget that the nature of the traditional institution in Yoruba land is different from some parts of the country. Because Obas are seen as next to the gods. So therefore, no mortal can query them. You can go ahead and do your coup and remove them, but you cannot query an Oba. So that is where I think the government needs to work on. And that is what they're trying to work on. The dilemma is that it's not the first time. You remember it has happened before when we used to have Oyo State. And the Alaafin Oni refused, the Alaafin refused to attend any Council of State meeting shared by Oni or Olubadan. And they had to create a separate traditional council for him. So both of them, they created the new state. Alaafin of Oyo is now in Oyo State. Oni of Ife is now in Osun State. That was how they were able to resolve it. And both of them are permanent chairmen in different parts of the in the two states. So what you see happening is also historical. It has a lot of impact, you know, on the people, on the history of the people, and therefore it's not what anybody can treat like the Sanusi's case. It's quite unlike that. In the north, the emirs are not seen as next to God.
That's right.
They are only seen as spiritual leader and the emir and the king. But in Southwest, it's totally different. And Oba is not only the leader, he's the spiritual leader,
he's
everything,
ruler.
He's a traditional ruler. In fact, he is next to the gods. So if he's next to the gods, even the priest of the traditional religion actually kowtow to the Obas. So therefore, people find it to be an affront. But I must say the governor is also right, because they are supposed to attend statutory functions, which they've been boycotting since August, and it's going to 9 months, going to a year. So this is where the issue is.
I mean, thank you for that background that you've brought to this, this whole new perspective. Now, having said that, let's talk about the Alaafin of Oyo's intervention, which some people are not quite happy with and saying he shouldn't intervene. How do you interpret that? Because he says he's advising a father, advising a son's role, but those who, to whom he is giving the advice do not see it as such. How do you respond to that?
Well, when you actually, I think the Alaafin's intervention is appropriate. You do not wait, and that is what was lacking in the case of Kano State. You don't wait until a problem becomes a crisis and gets out of control before leaders start speaking. It's in line with the history of the Southwest, is in line with the liberal tradition of the people, is in line with the expressive nature that somebody will challenge it somewhere. Alaafin is quite right. He has called the attention of the governor to certain realities, you know, that the governor himself is a product of Ekiti Parapọ, which is a struggle, you know, by the Ekiti people over domination. So, and consequently, he expected the governor as a son, you know, to behave in certain ways. The governor has since met the Alaafin at Ibadan, and he has done the needful. He prostrated, because in Yoruba land, the governor cannot, historically, if you go into history, be superior to Anoba, because Anoba is next to the gods. So that is what it is. And don't find it, you won't find it strange. If you remember when Obasanjo went, the former president went to visit, a two-time president went to visit the Onion Fife. He prostrated.
That's right.
No matter irrespective of age, because that is the history, culture, and tradition of the Yoruba people. So I think Alaafin's intervention is appropriate. He has done the needful. The governor has seen the point in what he's trying to say. Alaafin considers Kayode Fayemi as his son. That's the governor of Ekiti State. And the governor considered Alaafin, you know, as his father. So at times you have this disagreement, but there are ways to resolve it. And that is what I think those who have experienced it before, that is the traditional institution in Ife and Osun States, you know, and Oyo town, they are trying to get, trying to help resolve the problem using the benefit of their own historical experience. So I think that is what the issue is.
Thank you so very much, Mr. Showomi, for bringing history to this story, bringing perspective, and making us see a deeper part of it that we may not have known. It's interesting there.